Good morning, Yes Church. Good morning, it's so good to hear the nice, happy, joyful sound coming from the hallway. Come on in, because we're going to start to worship our Lord. You know, I was thinking way back, we're singing some Christmas songs today, and I was thinking way back, you know, you had to find a big star and follow it to a horse stable and see a baby. No wonder a lot of people miss that, right? But when Jesus comes back, we're not going to miss it, because that's not the way he's coming back. So hallelujah. I want to welcome you today. And whenever I get scripture that I think is good, well, it's all good. I shouldn't say good. But when it's about singing, I always try to bring it and share it. So today it's Colossians 3:16, and part of this will be very familiar to you. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another. But then there's this part. With all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. So as a worship team, we just want to bring that to you today. We want to bring you the Word of God through song, that you can just worship with gratitude in your hearts today. So I'm glad you came. I'm glad, and no, December's a busy month, but I'm glad you put aside time to come and worship God and hear the Word. So I think with that, we will start, and I'll just say a little prayer, Steve. Father, we just thank you for those that are here today. We thank you for your word that's rich, and may it dwell in us, Lord. And may we sing with gratitude in our hearts today for you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thanks, Nancy.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful.
Seated. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Christmas.
I know it's the first Sunday in Advent, but I just like saying that, so
amen.
I'm saying it.
Amen.
It's always good to be welcome everyone here and welcome to those watching online. Just draw your attention to the bulletin and the new calendar, and you'll see it's coming up. We have our monthly prayer meeting coming up on Wednesday, 7 till 8, so all are welcome to meet here in the sanctuary as we come before the Lord as a group and just bring our needs and our thanks, and just it's a good time to come together to pray for yourselves, pray for others, and have be prayed for. So just a reminder of that. Yes Fit continues on this week. Now, next Sunday, we have our pot blessing lunch, so please come, or stay, I should say, not come to church and then stay for the pot blessing. And it's in the big room downstairs, as always. And if you have a hot dish, we have a cold dish, we have a cooler. If you have a hot dish, we also have a warming warming oven. If you're making a dish with onions in it, you can put it in there. But so, and somebody will be down there when you arrive to bring it in and have it either kept cold, kept warm, or just room temperature, whatever works for you. So please note that on your calendar for this week, so we can just enjoy some time together at this Christmas time. You also notice that the Christmas sing-along on the 16th there, so that's another thing that's just great, once again, to be together, and we have an opportunity this year to join together with our new neighbors, Freedom House, and just come together, enjoy each other's fellowship, and just have a very enjoyable time together as we lift up our voices and praise and song, and just a great time to be together. Anything else that I'm forgetting? This one. Okay. Any birthdays today?
Where's Kathy Dean?
Pardon me? She's at the door.
With
okay.
Gemma.
Well, we may have to do a delayed Kathy Dean happy birthday then. So maybe we'll get Steve to go down and serenade her right at the show. I said maybe.
Maybe.
You've never done that type of thing where you serenade the crowd?
No. Aww.
Well, there's always a first for everything.
That's true.
Oh, there
That's
she
true,
is.
But it ain't happening today, right? Yeah, I saw her. Okay, well, any other birthdays? We'll revert any anniversaries here today. Well, let's, if you're watching online, you're having a birthday or anniversary, have a great one. We've got our first Sunday of Advent, just a wonderful time of year to gather together, and as the weeks go on, as Christmas approaches, it's just a time to really think about what happened that first Christmas time. So why don't we get up and greet one another, and then we'll, Kathy, I think she must have heard us talk.
Yeah, she's probably avoiding us.
I think I can see it. Yeah. Anyways, let's greet one another this morning.
All right.
Good morning officially to everyone. Only one left.
I take one.
Yeah.
I believe that it's the people that make up the church, and we're just so thankful that you've joined us online today. If you would like to make a donation, simply go to our website, yeschurch.ca, click the donate button. Again, thank you so much for joining us online today, and we look forward to hearing from you. Before we go, I'd just like to pray with you. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord God, I thank you. I thank you for the people, Lord. I thank you for the people that make up the church, Lord. And I just pray that for a special blessing over everyone viewing online today, Lord, and the people in our church, Lord. I just thank you for them, Lord. And I just pray that as we get back into worship, Lord, that you just send your Holy Spirit, Lord, and just wash over everybody. We thank you, we praise you, and we honor you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yes. Okay. Let's all stand
Kathy.
And stand and sing happy birthday to Kathy Dean.
Kathy.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Have a great day.
I catch up to you finally.
Yeah, for a few months.
Am I singing? Said the night wind to the little lamb. Do you see what I see?
Do you see what I see?
Way up in the sky, little lamb. See what I see.
Do you see what I see?
A star, dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite. Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear?
You hear what I hear?
Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
A song, high above the trees with a voice as big as the sea. With a voice as big as the sea. Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king. Do you know what I know?
Do you know what I know?
In your palace warm, mighty king. Do you know what I know?
Do you know what I know?
A child, shivers in the cold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Let us bring him silver and gold. Said the king to the people everywhere. Listen to what I say.
Listen to what I say.
Pray for peace, people everywhere. Listen to what I say. The child sleeping in the night, he will bring us goodness and light. He will bring us goodness and light. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Told me ba-rum-bum-bum-bum, a newborn king to see, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum,
our finest gifts we bring. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. To lay before the king. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. Rum-bum-bum-bum. Rum-bum-bum-bum. So to honor. To give a king, ba rum bum bum bum, rum bum bum bum, rum bum bum bum. Shall I play for you, ba rum bum bum bum? My drum. Mary nodded, ba rum bum bum. Played my drum for him, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. I played my breast for him, ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. Rum-bum-bum-bum, rum-bum-bum-bum. He smiled at me, ba-rum-bum-bum. My drum, me and my drum.
I love playing Christmas songs.
I do too. Yeah.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. He's been my fourth man in the fire, time after time. Born of the Spirit, washed in His blood, and what He did for me on Calvary is more than enough. I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail. I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail. Submission, all is at rest. I know the author of tomorrow did my best. So this is my story, this is my song, praising my risen King and Savior. I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail. I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail. Thank you. I sought the Lord and he heard and he answered. I sought the Lord and he heard and he answered. I sought the Lord and he heard and he answered. That's why I trust him. That's why I trust him. I sought the Lord and he heard and he answered. I sought the Lord and he heard and he answered. I sought the Lord and he heard and he answered. That's why I trust him. That's why I trust him. God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail. I trust in God, my Savior, the one who will never fail. He will never fail. Moving in our midst, I worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place, I worship you, I worship you.
You are here, Lord.
You are here, moving in. Worship you, I worship you. You are here, working in this place. I worship you, I worship you. You are May Maker, Miracle Worker, Promise Keeper, Light in the Darkness, my God. That is who you are.
You are our way maker.
You are way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. You are here, touching every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you, I worship you. You are here, darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are a way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 Stop working, you never stop working.
darkness, my God, that is who you are. 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 That is who you are.
Father God, we thank you for being here with us today. Lord, you always are with us.
Hallelujah.
And you are our way maker, Lord. Yes. This Advent season that we have going on here right now, Lord, it's the time of year that you did send us the way, Lord. You did send us the way, and we're so thankful for that.
Thank
Lord.
You, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
The first Sunday of Advent, wonderful time of year. It's always great to start this season together, lighting the first candle to welcome Jesus into the world. There are many meanings behind the Advent candles, the Advent time of the year. Here are just a few. The wreath is a circle, no beginning, no end, a symbol for God, the eternal one, without beginning and without end. The wreath is made of evergreen, green, the color that reminds us of life, reminds us of the first growth at the beginning of spring. We can think of that new life we have, each of us, in the Lord Jesus Christ. The candles represent the light of God coming into the world. The four red candles as we wait the 4 weeks of Advent leading to Christmas time. Also, we think of the color red, representing the blood that Jesus shared for each of us. And the white candle, the Christ candle, as we wait and come to Christmas Eve and celebrate the first coming of our Lord and Savior, and look forward to his return. I'll ask Joanne and Maria to come forward and light the first Advent candle. Or is she going to hold? Okay.
The first candle, the prophecy candle, or candle of hope. We can have hope because God is faithful and will keep the promises made to us. Our hope comes from God. The reading today is from Romans 15, 12, and 13. And again, Isaiah says, "The root of Jesse will spring up, one who will arise to rule over the nations. The Gentiles will hope in him. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit."
Thank you, ladies. As we go through this Advent season, I just want you to make note of the people that are lighting the Advent candles. They're longtime members of Yes Church. All have been here for well over 20 years plus. So I just wanted to mention that, and you'll see as the weeks go on, as the people come up to light the Advent candles. The title of this morning's message is Christmas Stockings Full of Love. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this Christmas time, that we can celebrate the first coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, as we read the scriptures and hear about some of our Christmas traditions that honor you, help us to learn and focus on the true meaning of Christmas. In Jesus' name, amen. For those regularly attend, you'll notice that as it does at different times through the year, the cross has changed its position on the platform. I always like to do that just to help us kind of maybe jog what we're seeing and the fact that the cross should always be a focus in our lives. But at Christmas time, we combine it with the cross and bring out the manger, because we know that when Jesus arrived and was placed in a manger that first Christmas, we know that the shadow of the cross was over that manger. There are many things that we do to celebrate the coming of our Savior, or do to help and bless others through this Christmas season. Many of our Christmas traditions we find come from church history. I read a sermon by Pastor Robert J. Morgan. He had some great information about one of our long-observed Christmas traditions and talked about God's love for us. I learned that hanging our stockings by the fireplace is just about the first and oldest tradition that we follow. Living in the year 2023 and throughout most of our lifetimes, most of us have had plenty of clothes to dress ourselves each day. But in reality, for most people down through history, they didn't have extensive wardrobes. Because of that, here's something that I don't know if any of us would be quite happy about doing every night, but something that you did was you washed out your stockings, your socks, and hung them by the fireplace to dry for the next day. That's what was just part of it, because you only had one pair of socks. The only thing worse than that would be sitting at breakfast next to a person that didn't wash out their socks the night before. History tells us that there was a very resourceful teenager from the city of Patra on the Mediterranean coast in ancient Turkey. His name was Nicholas. For some of you, this story may be causing you to think, this sounds very familiar. Nicholas had just entered the ministry and appeared to be a very resourceful young man. He became a quite popular and beloved bishop in the city of Myra. Part of Pastor Nicholas's duties appeared to be traveling to other cities on ministry trips. He found himself in a certain city, and while there he heard about a man whose wife had passed away. He was doing his best to raise his three daughters. Things were not going well. They were very poor, and the family was on the verge of starvation. Because of their dire financial state, the man couldn't provide a dowry for any of his daughters. Tradition at that time meant with no dowry, no husband. No family would allow their son to marry a woman without a dowry. The situation was becoming so bad that they were in danger of being sold into slavery. Pastor Nicholas felt a huge burden for this family. He knew he had to figure out a way to help them. So one night he went to their home, and looking through the window, he could see the eldest daughter's stocking hanging by the fireplace. Reaching through the window, he tossed a coin into her stocking. And reportedly, he did the same thing for the other two girls. This is how the tradition started, that on St. Nicholas Day, children would hang their stockings by the fireplace, and in the morning would find that during the night, a treat would have been put in their stocking. The tradition of the Christmas stocking is appropriate to observe at Christmas because it symbolizes the truth of the gospel. Like the poor family in the story, we're grief-stricken, we're impoverished at heart, we're enslaved by sin and unable to save ourselves. In a very different way, on Christmas Day, God puts something into our stockings. He has put something far better than gold. He has put in the feet of his own dear son, feet that were to be nail-pierced for our sins. I ask you to turn to 1 John 3, verse 1. John 3, 1. It tells us, see what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know Him. We're looking at God's incredible love for each of us. The first words in 1 John 3:1 is a Greek term meaning, look at this, become aware of this, consider this. The older translations of the Bible use the word behold, a word that's not much used much anymore. What the Lord is saying to us is, hey, look at this, pay attention to what I'm teaching you. He's saying, stop what you're doing and listen to me. I want to show you something. He wants us to concentrate on what He is telling us. The Lord wants us to see what kind of love the Father has given us, that we, you and I, would be called children of God. Stop and think about that. Stop thinking about anything else that may be on your mind right now, maybe a Christmas present you're going to buy someone, or what are you having for lunch? Just stop thinking about anything else and concentrate on what we just read in verse 3. See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. Children of God. That is who you are when you know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. Has it sunk in how incredible that is? Or are you having a hard time putting it all together in your head? We have a tendency to do that. We have a tendency when we're given and read those promises to think about all the mistakes we've made. How can I be a child of God? I'm not perfect. He's not calling upon us to be perfect. The only perfect one that walked this earth was Jesus Himself. He's calling on us to trust in Him and believe what He tells us. The fact that you are a child of God. Turn to 1 John 3:16. John 3:16. This is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down His life for us. When we look and think about God's love, it's Jesus we're looking at. It's Jesus we're thinking about. If you stop and think about it, when you look at the Bible, There are two John 3:16s. The first from John 3:16 from the gospel that most of us are familiar with, you can probably recite by heart. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. And 1 John 3:16. This is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for us. Think about it this way. If you could draw one picture for the world to depict the concept of love. We have many different ideas of what we would draw. But it wouldn't be a wedding ring, or a sensual embrace, or a romantic candle, or a sacrificial act of kindness. What it would be the cross of Jesus Christ, the greatest showing of love that's ever happened. Turn to 1 John 4. I'm going to be reading verses 7 to 19. First John 4, verse 7. The NIV, the title for this section is God's Love and Ours. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us. This is how we know that we live in him, and he in us. He has given us his Spirit. And we have seen and testified that the Father has sent his Son to be the Savior of the world. If anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God lives in them, and they in God. And so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God, and God in them. This is how love has made complete among us, so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. In this world, we are like Jesus. There is no fear in love. But perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because he first loved us. Words that we can always count on, words that we know are true. No matter what, no matter where we are, no matter what's going on in our lives, in the good times, in the bad times, in the happy times, in the sad times. We know that he is always with us, that he always loves us. There never comes a time where he says, oh, you've messed up again, I don't love you anymore. As humans, we do that. But God never does that. He loves us all the time. We know that he is with us when our strength fails. He's with us when a close friend or a family member passes away. We can trust in God when our hearts break, when it feels like our minds are reeling. We can trust him. We can trust him when our biggest hopes are dashed, when our health fails. We can always rely on the love of God because His love is embodied in our Lord Jesus Christ. Remember what 1 John 3:16 tells us. This is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down His life for us. This verse is telling us, whatever you're facing now, whatever you will face in the future, you can rely on Jesus. Because of Him, we don't need to be afraid of anything in this life. We can always rely on the fact that whatever comes, God loves us, and His perfect love casts out fear. Even at Christmas time, we can feel lonely. It's even possible to have a case of the Christmas blues right at the start of the season. But always remember, God loves you, and you can rely on that love 100% of the time. There's never a moment that that love is not on you. And His perfect love casts out fear. Keep these words in your mind. Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. And that's who you are, a child of God. Because the Heavenly Father put the feet of Jesus Christ into your Christmas stocking 2,000 years ago in Bethlehem. You have a stocking full of love. Because of His incredible love for you. End with this poem from Pastor Morgan. He left His Father's throne above so free, so infinite His grace, emptied Himself of all but love, and bled for Adam's helpless race. 'Tis mercy all, immense and free, for, O my God, it found out me. Let us pray. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you gave up everything for us. It's impossible to understand completely the blessing you bestowed upon each of us. Lord, you call on us each day to draw closer to you, to be more like you and walk in your ways in all things. Lord, help us to seek you through reading the Bible, praying, and listening to you daily. Fill us with your wisdom in all things. Lord, help us to remember the words that we read from the Bible this morning, Lord. And remember each moment of each day how much you love us. Thank you for this Christmas season as we celebrate your first coming and look forward to your return. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Larry.
Thank you, Pastor Larry. What an awesome message to know that he loves us so much.
Right.
Yeah. I'd like to sing Waymaker again instead of the song that we were going to do, because I think it's more fitting to what your message was all about today.
Waymaker, miracle.
worship you. We worship you. You are here.
Let's give the Lord another clap of praise. Thank you, team, for leading us in our praise. What an incredible way to start the week is praising the Lord. Remember, through this Christmas season, with all the distraction there are, keep focused on what it's all about. Keep focused on the fact that it's all about the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. And remember the scripture that we read today. No matter what happens in these coming days, in these coming weeks, whether it's through circumstance, whether it's through other people, remember that God loves you unconditionally, 100% of the time, and that you are a child of God. Never forget that. Amen. Make a good week. God bless.
Thanks, Steve.